Hello everyone, welcome to LICD lecture 12E. Today's topic is floating load V2I converter. So last time we have seen simple voltage to current conversion. Simplest way, we have a passive circuit. Now this is an active circuit, that is op-amp based voltage to current conversion. So there are two techniques in it. One is floating load V2I converter. One is grounded load V2I converter. So let us dig in directly to floating load V2I converter. This is also called as active floating load V2I converter. So what do you mean by floating load? So if none of the terminals of a load is connected to a ground, then it is called as a floating load. So let us consider this example over here. If you see at the outside, this is nothing but basically a non-inverting amplifier, but we are analyzing it in terms of floating load V2I converter. Now, same circuit having two functionalities. Well, that's strange. So over here, this is my load resistance RL, which is marked with this red color, and the current flowing through the load is IL. So the current flowing through R1 resistor is I1. Now, since no current flows into the op-amp terminals, the IL current will be same as I1. That's what we have written over here. And since we are using a negative feedback, your virtual short concept will be applicable. That means that if V plus is equal to V in, then V minus also will acquire the value of V in. Okay, so let us start with the analysis. So from the circuit, we can write V plus is equal to V in. And by virtual ground concept, we can write V minus is also approximately equal to V in. So let I1 be the current flowing through R1 and let IL be the current flowing through RL basically. And we'll apply the KCL at this node, V minus. So what does the KCL say? Incoming current is equal to outgoing currents. So over here, IL will be equal to I1 plus I minus. So IL will be equal to I1 plus I minus. But I minus is equal to zero, since the input impedance of the op-amp is tremendously high. Hence, we can write IL equal to I1. And from the circuit, what can we write about I1? So I1 will be, how we can write the value of I1 over here? Yeah. So let us check it back. Yeah. So what will be I1? I1 will be V minus minus 0 upon R1. Again, I repeat, I1 will be current flowing through resistor R1 will be V minus minus 0 upon R1. So that's what we get over here. Yeah. I1 is V minus minus 0 upon R1, but V minus is approximately equal to V in by virtual short technique. So I1 will be equal to V in upon R1. So your similarly, if I1 is also same as IL, so we can write IL is equal to V in upon R1. That means IL is proportional to V in. Okay, because R1 is a constant. That means the load current is directly proportional to the input voltage. Okay, so this is one example of a voltage to current conversion. So the above circuit behaves as a voltage to current converter. So in the above expression, that is IL equal to V in upon R1, there is no load resistance appearing, unlike in case of a passive V2I converter. So that's a big advantage. That means the output current IL is independent of RL. So in this system, voltage to current converter system, output is a current, input is a voltage. So what will be the gain? Output upon input, right? So the output will be current and the input will be voltage. What will be the unit? Conductance. Now, since there is a transfer of this voltage to the output current, we call it as a transconductance amplifier. And here in this expression, if I take IL divided by V in, what do we get? Yeah. So the term mod of IL divided by V in equal to 1 upon R1 is the sensitivity of the circuit. We have already seen what is sensitivity. Sensitivity higher means it can even convert very low voltages into currents, or it can detect very low voltages or currents. Now let us, analyze this floating load V2I converter in more details. So let us say this is my circuit number A. We have already derived a formula. So in circuit number A, the op-amp outputs whatever the current IL it takes to make the inverting input terminal follow V in. So basically what they are trying to say is V minus is equal to V in. And the same current flows through R1 and RL. That's what they are making, the statement. And here we have already derived that IL is 1 upon R1 into V in. IL is the output load current and V in is the input voltage. So that's equation number one. So this equation number one will hold regardless of the type of the load. So the load can be a linear load like a resistive transducer, or it can be a non-linear, which is a diode, right? So no matter what the load, the op-amp will be forced to carry the current IL equal to Vin upon R1. Yeah, that is correct. Which depends upon the control voltage Vin and the current setting resistor R1, but not on the load voltage. That is very, very clear from this expression. And from circuit, we can write Vout equal to VL plus Vin. Now, where does this came from? Yeah. So Vout is equal to VL and Vin. Both are there, right? So here KVL says that Vout will be equal to VL plus V minus, and V minus is Vin basically. So hence we can write Vout is equal to VL plus Vin, where VL is nothing but IL into RL. So to achieve the not any dependence on the load voltage also. So as you can see over here, the output is still depending upon the load voltage. So we have to take into account this. That means the output voltage should be a little bit more accountable and flexibility in terms of the peak-to-peak amplitude at the output. So to achieve this goal, the op-amp must swing its output to a value which is Vout equal to Vin plus VL. Okay, so that's very important. Now some important definition, voltage compliance. It is a range of permissible values of VL for which the circuit still works properly before the onset of saturation starts. Okay. So basically all these examples will be clear more clear when we'll discuss some numerical or LTSpice numerical on this. Okay, voltage compliance is also very important. So basically op amps are powered with plus or minus VCC and VEE power supply. So a maximum output voltage which can be achievable within the op amp is plus or minus VSAT. So if VCC and VEE are plus or minus 15 volts, plus or minus VSAT will be close to around 0.9 VCC, that is around 13.5 volts. This means that in circuit A, Vout equal to Vin plus VL is valid as long as Vout is restricted to this, limit. That means Vout cannot be greater than V plus and cannot be less than V plus and cannot be greater than V minus. It is well within this range only. So what will be the voltage compliance of the circuit? So voltage compliance will be VL has to be less than VSAT minus Vin, and VL has to be greater than minus VSAT minus Vin. So that's what the voltage compliance of this circuit looks like. Okay. Now let us look into some different variety of circuit now. Same floating load I2V converter, but with a different style. So here we have connected the input to the inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal is open. So here the current is flowing into the resistor R1 and into the resistor RL, and this is my load basically. So here we can write at the start, we can write V plus is approximately equal to 0. So V minus is approximately equal to 0 because it is a virtual ground. Then the output terminals must draw the current, V in, it is V in minus V minus upon R1. So what will be IL? IL will be V in minus V minus upon R1. So V minus is 0. So IL is basically V in upon R1. And it must have the output swing as. So here we will have an output swing of, minus VL. Why minus VL? Because here it is, if you write a KVL, we'll get V minus minus VL minus V out is equal to 0. So what will be V out equal to? V out will be equal to minus of VL. That's what we have. So the output voltage must have an output swing of VL, V out equal to minus VL. Hence the voltage compliance of this circuit will be VL less than or greater than, it should be less than plus VSAT, greater than minus VSAT. That's what it is telling us. But the only drawback of circuit number B is that, you know, the current should be provided by the voltage source, Vin. So the IL, so the current IL must come from the source Vin itself. So that's the drawback. Now, we have discussed circuit number A and B. What are the observations? So the equation IL equal to Vin upon R1 holds true both for circuit A and B, regardless of the polarity of Vin. The current arrows of a circuit A and B shows that the current for Vin greater than zero and for making Vin less than zero will simply make the directions of the current reverse. So the two converters, that is circuit A and B, are thus said to be bidirectional. And the maximum current either circuit can deliver to the load depending upon the op-amp is around 25 milliamperes. And for 741 op-amp, this value is around 25 milliamperes only. So that's it. I think for today, we have discussed today a little bit, on the floating load V2I converter into a little bit more details. This is just for understanding. Okay, so we have come to a conclusion of this lecture. Next time, we'll build another application using op-amp. Until then, have a good day and thank you.